All right. You know there's a ton of tutorials out there for beginners for Fusion 360, but... And I know you think there's no way I could design something like that. And I don't mean by I as in me, I mean you. But I'm going to show you how easy Fusion 360 is to get some really complex shapes and complex models, even for the very, very beginner. So let's get started. All you need to get started with Fusion 360 is a mouse, a three-button mouse. You need the clicker in the middle. And keyboard. That's it. Now, during this tutorial, you're gonna see me move around my model really fast. It's because I'm using a 3D mouse, but you don't need a 3D mouse. If you get really into Fusion, eventually you'll definitely want to get one, but you don't need one starting out. Okay, let's start with basic navigation, and I'm outside of my program because it's easier to understand. When you click the middle button on your mouse, it allows you to pan the model around. You can just move it around. It's like you're looking at it from a different angle on the same table. If you need to move your model around, you've got this really cool cube up here, and you can just pull it around any way you want. And if you click on any one of the sides, it goes to that side. And if you ever get confused, you just hit the little home button, and it takes you right back to your original view. Now, the only other thing you really need to know outside is that when to orbit, you need to hit the shift button and then middle click. And when you middle click and hit the shift button, this allows you to orbit around. And think about it like grabbing the model and pulling it around. So if I grab it down here and push up, and I can move it around this way. So that's shift and middle mouse button. So there's a million different ways to start off a project like this, but I'm gonna do it with a box because I think it's the easiest for you to understand. So the reason I'm using a box specifically is so I can get basic measurements before I start my project. So I have an idea of how big things are. This is 6 inches by about 3, you know, it's actually 3.5 inches. But it gives me a good place to start so I know how big my entire project is gonna be. Now I just go to, I go to Canvas, and I'm gonna insert a canvas. You can find these vehicle blueprints all over the place, and it's such an easy way to knock out something just really cool. So what I'm doing right here is I'm just taking this canvas and I'm gonna put it up against my block. Now remember, the reason I am using this block is because it gives me an idea of how big my final project is, and I want to be able to 3D print it. So I'm just keeping it inside this box. That way I know it's only going to be about 6 inches long, so it'll 3D print pretty well. Okay, so now I have my canvas up against my block of wood, and I call this the block of wood method. I think it's just one of the easiest ways to do stuff. And now I'm going to trace using my sketch tools. So I just opened up a new sketch, and then now I have all my sketch tools ready to go. So the easiest thing to remember is you're just going to use lines for straight parts and use curves for curved parts. So every time I finish a line, I am going to hit the check mark. If you don't, it'll just continue the line, and it's to help you go faster. But specifically for this project, I'm using it so I can jam through and just show you where I would lay out straight lines and where I would lay out curved lines. So there's a continuous line. That's a good example of when you'd use a continuous line. Okay, I see, it looks like pretty much that's most of the straight lines. Oh, there's a straight line right here. And remember, right now it's on snap, that's okay. If you zoom in, it'll get you, give you a closer closer perspective to snap to. But, and now I'm gonna use my fit point spline. Splines are really easy to use. You start at a point, and then you just mark points along your curve, and it'll do kind of the rest of it for you. See, I need something a little bit closer. Like, that's good right there. Okay, now watch what happens. Once I hit my last one, I hit stop. And so this one got a little screwed up. That's all right. So I put a point in the middle and then put an end point. Now I'm good. And, you know, just like you saw, I just stopped the spline once I got to where I need. Now, remember, you need one point in between your start and your stop to make it curve. Bam. Okay. Remember, it just has to be close. We're not pros. We're not trying to design a real car. So just keep it close to the shape, especially for this project. Anytime a spline changes directions, you need to start a new one, because if you try to get it to fit to where it was, what'll happen is it won't quite come out right. Now I'm gonna hit this little curve part right here too. I'm just gonna use lines for this, and you'll see why, because cutting this out of a block of wood, this'll work out a little bit better, I think. But I want to use curves down here. So every time I want to stop, I just hit escape. Now come back, use another spline. Remember, you need one point in the middle at least. So, oops, I didn't hit finish yet. So one point in the middle, and then come down here. Now I forgot to hit the check mark. One point in the middle, then come down here. Boom, it looks pretty good. Oops, I'm in line now. Spline. Bam, okay, that's good. Now I'm gonna use straight lines across this part right here. And I'm gonna use straight lines here too, just because I think it'll be faster. Okay, I'm good right there. Okay, so now I need my curves here. This will be easy with splines. Remember, I'm just zooming in with my scroll wheel on my mouse. And it just gives me a little bit more options to get closer to where I want to be. Just kind of watch that curve. If you need it, if it's acting a little weird on you, just use two curves instead of one. That's good. Check. Now I'm gonna go over here. And just tracing this out, finding points along the way. And when you're using splines, try to find points that look like significant changes in the curve itself. And that'll give you a little bit better final result. So anywhere the curve looks like it changes a little bit, that's where you want to put a point. And just like I said, if the curve changes into another direction, you definitely want to use a separate one for that. Okay, looks like we're pretty good with the basic outline. I'm gonna put a few more details in here really quick because it helps and makes it faster later on when I go into shape the side. But you don't have to do this when you're first starting out, but it helps. The one big thing you do need to do is make sure that everything is closed. So make sure you do have a closed curve, especially on the outside. All right, so I'm gonna take a second and do a few more details. Still in my sketch, circles are pretty self-explanatory, but the big thing here is for wheels are actually really easy. All you have to do is get each part of the wheel, get a circle for it, and to keep the wheels the same across your project, one of the easiest things to do is, now that I've done it, I just hold my shift key, or control does the same thing, and it lets you select several things. Control C,
Control V, and that is just copy and paste, same thing as you're used to in most other programs. And I just bring that wheel over, and now I know my wheels are the same. Just hit enter, bam. And one more thing I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to do the interior too of the car. And I mean interior as in the bottom underneath it. And just understand, you're just laying these lines down because you're going to use these lines later. You'll see why I do this later, but sometimes you need to throw in some geometry that's not on here. And because it's subtle, and once you see how I use this geometry later on, to remember, I'm cutting this out of a block of wood, so I need a transition right here, even though there's not a line there in my model. But you'll see how I use that later on. Okay, you can see basically the block behind my car. Now, there's two ways you could do this, but I just want to show you what project and include does. If I go down to, so I'm in my sketch still, project, include, project. What it does is it will project the geometry that's sitting behind your sketch. And you can do this to anything. Even if it's like a sphere or something, it'll make a circle, obviously, on your sketch. So it's just a really cool, fast way to get an outline of what's behind your sketch. Okay, now that we're done with our sketch, I need to cut this out of my little block of wood, right? So what I want to do is my initial shape is I want the initial side shape of the car. So I need to cut away the excess. Pretty simple, right? Now I don't want these pieces right here. So to select several things, I'm going to hit Shift. Control does the same thing. And I want to cut these pieces out too, because I will do the wheels completely separate. And I just want to show you initially. This is so much fun. This is why 3D modeling is so cool. Now that I've got it selected, I could go up here and do this, press pull. I usually just do right click, press pull. It's the same thing. And I'm just going to cut it out of my block of wood. Bam. So super easy, right? So every time you go from a one thing to another, you just need to clean everything up and get everything out of the way that you're not using. So I want to get rid of this sketch so it doesn't get in my way. But I want to come back here to my canvas, and I'm just going to move it to where we're going to use the front profile now. So it's pretty simple. I just click on the canvas over here, and then I tell it I want to move it. Bam, 90 degrees, and then I'm going to slide it over. And the reason I like these custom blueprints you can find on places like Pinterest and stuff like that is they have everything to scale already. If you get kind of a random one, you'll have to kind of do the scale on your own for this trick. But I'm just going to go back in here and do the same thing. I'm going to trace this out. This time, luckily, I have a plane to use. So you can go back here and see your planes. See how it shows that plane, this plane. Once you start modeling, it automatically disappears. But if you ever need it back, you can just go over here and see it again. The reason I mention it right here is because if I try to start a sketch right on my canvas, it won't let me. It needs a plane to do it from. So I'll come back to the sketch in a second. So I've got a pretty good flat surface right there on my model, but that's not good because it's not perfectly flat. So that's why I want to use a plane, so I know it's, you know, exactly 90 degrees to this side that we used. Now, I got lucky. My model is sitting on the right-hand side, or not right on the plane. But if I needed to, I needed another plane, I would just use this orientation again, do construct, offset plane. But it's usually the default one. And then I would click on there, and then I put my plane wherever I need it. So now I have an extra plane to use, and then I can sketch on top of this. You just can't sketch on top of canvases. They're not considered planes by themselves. So you have to create a plane. So an easy way to do it is offset plane. But for this, I don't really need that, so I'm gonna get rid of it. I try to get rid of everything I don't need. It keeps your modeling process a lot cleaner. All right, now I'm just gonna go ahead and sketch on this plane. I've already got a sketch going on. If you just click on it, it doesn't do anything. You have to right click and then edit sketch, and then that will put you back into the sketch sketch mode. So now, just like we did on the side, I'm going to use mostly lines, and I'm just going to go through and get a good basic profile of my model here. Now, one of the cool things about 3D modeling is, remember, you don't have to do things twice if they're symmetric. So what I am going to do, I did not mean to make a curve right there, is, ooh, that is kind of a curve though. So I'm gonna use my spline. Boom. Oh, it's not, I want it to be a new one. So I'm just going to do one side. And this is actually a curve. Now I'll show you how you find the center of something. You, it automatically does it with lines. So if I do a line from here all the way across to the same point on the other side, click. Since I've done that, now it'll show me where the midpoint is. And since now I have the midpoint, I just go 90 degrees up from there. And luckily this point is at 90 degrees. If it wasn't, I would just cross right through and then actually place a point to make sure I was at halfway through. So I've got half my car and it looks pretty good. It's pretty close enough for what we're trying to do here. Okay, so now I need to cut away everything that's not on this half. Once again, I showed you there's a couple of different ways to do this. You could just project. There's actually a much simpler way. Go back to my sketch. I accidentally fell out of my sketch mode. And just do a rectangle. So just do a rectangle that encompasses your entire piece. So I can see the wood back there. I can see it's back there. You don't have to do it perfect. Just do it bigger. Do finish, and you see now I have something to cut away that block behind it. Once again, I always hide stuff so it looks clean, so I can see what I'm doing. And when you do press pull on sketches, it automatically, if you go through something, it automatically does cut, but you can change it to intersect, you can change it to join. So you know, for this, I need it to cut. Also, you can do, there's other options under here when you cut one object with another. And they're basically self-explanatory when you see that, but that's when you cut from one to another. Okay, so now I have the basic layout of my car. Right, pretty cool. All right, and let me show you. I actually want to use this right-hand side because that's where my sketch is. I'll come back to that in a second. Okay, so we've done the side profile. We did the front profile. Now we do the top. And that's why it's so cool to find blueprints that have all three dimensions. They have the top, side, and front. It makes this so much easier. So if you're going to do a project, try to find one of those because it makes it super easy. So now I need to put my, grab my canvas again. Now I need to move it again. Remember, a lot easier to grab stuff over here because it designates what you're trying to do. If you try to grab stuff just willy-nilly, it tends to grab the surfaces and things like that. And there's a precedence for what it actually selects. Even if I try to grab the whole thing, believe it or not, it's not grabbing the whole thing. It's grabbing all the surfaces because it thinks you want to mess with the surfaces, not the model itself. So if I need to move a model, I just go over here and select it. Well, it's the same thing with anything in Fusion. So if I want to grab this canvas, easier to grab it over here under where it is in canvases. Now I need to move it. So I can either click it up here or I just use the shortcut menu because move is your real common commands are in the shortcut menu, which is just a right click. Now I want it at 90 degrees. I want it up above so I can, you know, cut down through my model. And as you can see, I need to turn it 90 degrees and move it over. And I'm just going to place it exactly where it needs to go. Zoom in so I kind of know I'm getting this pretty good. Now, it's pretty easy to get off center. The easiest thing to do is if you need a specific perspective, use your little block. I want it to be perfectly on top of my model, so I go over here and click top. Now I know I'm looking directly straight down. Okay, it looks pretty good. So we're good there. Now remember what I said, you can't draw straight on top of a canvas. See, I'm trying to left click it, there's nothing there. So I need a plane. But this plane down here is too low. But so all I have to do is do a offset plane. Grab this one, come up, make sure it's above, it is, and make sure it's above my model. Perspectives kind of get off sometimes, that's why it's so cool to just look at it from the side or whatever first. Now I need to go back to top. Okay, so now I want my sketch right here. Okay, so now I'm looking at it correctly, and I am going to do the same thing I did before. Notice what I did. I'm actually on the wrong side, so I'm glad I caught that. But no biggie. Move this over. Pretty close. All right, now I'm on the right side. Okay, go back to my sketch, right click, edit. Now I'm back in my sketch mode. A lot of curves in the top profile. See how it'll actually snap to the geometry underneath? It's just kind of a shortcut. If I really, really needed this geometry underneath, I would do project and project that geometry. But this is close is good enough for this project, like I said before. Oh, there's a little flat spot right there. Now, I want to catch that because, believe it or not, when you catch these little details, man, it makes your model look so much better. So I wanted to catch that little flat spot. Come back over here to my curve. And remember, just place those points along that curve where they look like they're doing good work. All right. I think that's pretty much it. And then this is pretty much a straight line down the side of this car. I guess Dodge Chargers are like that. I used to have a Dodge Charger when I was younger. Interesting to see it comes out here a little bit before it starts to curve. Great car. I used to love it. It was a lot of fun. It was way too heavy though. It didn't feel very fast. It had a giant engine, but it just didn't even feel that cool because it was such a heavy, big car. Okay, catching that geometry. And don't want that to curve. Yeah, why not? All right, we'll put it to there. Then we use a straight line to come all the way down. Nope, that curve looks a little weird. See how it dips in? I don't want to do that. That'll create a little seam and it'll look weird. So let me just delete that. Let me fix this. And what'll happen is if you accidentally, when you're doing a curve, say I want to come around this way, if I do one a little bit too shallow, then I go further out, it screws up your curve because it goes the wrong direction. So you gotta be careful with that. So to make sure your curves are smooth, make sure each point is on the outside of the curve. See, if I go back in, it'll go too far in. So I'm just gonna, I'm actually just gonna say I'm good right there and then use a straight line, come straight down, bam. Now I need to make sure everything's connected. Looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna use a straight line, come all the way across. And connect. You see how it filled in? If you miss a point and it's not connected, it won't fill in like that. But that's exactly what I wanted. Now remember, shortcut, I'm just going to use a rectangle to get an outside shape to cut. It's just the easiest way to do it. All right, so I have my outside shape. And now I can just cut. So I'll turn it sideways so you can see it. Or grab it, right click, press pull, bam. And this is a fantastic way to get a basic shape to start with. And the basic shapes inside 3D modeling are called primitives. So now I have a pretty good primitive to start with. And now let's go. Nope, I don't want to do that. I just want to close these so I can see what I'm doing. Go back up to my bodies. Select the one body that I have. Go down to create. I can mirror that. And you don't even need to come up with a plane. You can use a piece on the model itself. I'm going to use the plane right here because I know it's flat. So, great example. You got to be careful of what you're selecting and in what order. So, mirror function, the first click is the object, not a surface. You want to grab the whole object. And if you usually if you click on an edge of an object, it'll select the whole object. So I want to grab the whole object. And then last time I accidentally just clicked because it didn't do it automatically because it's asking me if I want to select something else. Now I need to go over here and tell it I want to select the plane that I want to use. If I use this one, my piece would be way over here. I want to use this plane so it'll be perfect across. And bam, automatically it pulled it over and pulled it in correctly. So we have a really good basic shape to start modeling with. Isn't that awesome? I mean, it's just really not that hard. Cars are really easy because mostly their dimensions are usually boxy anyway. So it's just kind of a trick that I use. That didn't work. Now that I'm going to go in and start making some details on the side and catch some of that geometry, one of the big things I'm going to do here is I want to be able to remember use that mirror function again. So I need a plane to do that, and it's kind of hard to tell where the middle of this is now. So one of the cool things is you can do a plane through two surfaces. It's called mid-plane. So I select here. Now I know that this and this are the same. So if I do here and here, see how it puts a mid-plane in there? Now I can split my body up in the middle. I don't want to do it right now. I don't need to, but I'm going to leave that plane in there, and I can always come back and use that. I'm going to hide it so it doesn't junk up my process here. And then I'm going to come back over here to my sketches. Remember my original sketch? Bam, all that geometry is still there, ready to go. So, first thing I want to cut out and first thing I want to work on is I'm going to work on this wheel well a little bit. I'm going to do them both at the same time. And now you're into, since this is a piece of geometry that's kind of inside and hard to see in a side profile, you got to kind of wing this one. But don't worry about it, you can always come back and fix it later. So I'm going to put it in, about that good. I need enough space for my tires, my wheels and everything to go into there. But look at that, looks pretty good, right? So you see what I'm doing? I'm just cutting pieces out of my vehicle. And I'm using the geometry that I already have. And I know you're excited to see how this works. This is pretty cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this geometry and I'm going to make a cut into the side of my car. Now, once I do that, now that the geometry is inside my model, I can adjust it. So I'm just going to simply start with a cut to get things going. Press pull, cut into the side of my model. Now, see, I'm going way too far, right? That's okay. I'm doing that on purpose because I need two surfaces. Okay, now I want this to be separate, and I want this to show up too. All right, so now I have two surfaces. Let me hide my sketch to work with. Okay, they obviously don't look like that, and they don't look that far together in the real model, but this gives me something to be able to adjust. So now I can grab it. All right, check this out. I'm gonna grab this geometry, and now that I have it, I can move it around. Now, a lot of times you gotta be careful. Once your geometry starts getting a little bit more complex, sometimes you can't move it around this easily. But right now, things are still pretty simple. I don't want to move it that much because I see how it comes out right here. That'll actually disappear, but this is when I'll go in and manually adjust. So let's try 2.5. Oops, too many points in there. Ooh, 2.5 works perfect. Bam. Okay. Now, let me chew this geometry down a little bit. Select, lets me grab different things. And now I'm gonna use my chamfer, whatever. And then go in, see how it only let me do it a little bit, but that's good enough. That's really kind of all I need right there. All right, it looks pretty cool. I could actually probably just, let's see what happens if I get rid of this. You get rid of that and it gives me a pretty good, yeah, man, that's pretty dang close, actually. I might want to pull this out just a tiny bit. It's because it's a little over the top. So I can move this surface, remember? But I want to tilt it out this way, but I want to do it from a pivot point over here. So the way you do that is you change the pivot point. So I go over here and set pivot, click it, say I want it to be over here. And you have to find a piece of geometry to anchor it down on. Now you're not done. You got to go over here and say, yes, that's where exactly where I want it. Now, watch what happens. Okay, that's 5. That's way too much, right? I really probably only want about 1. Let's try 1. Bam. Let's try 1.5. Oh, even closer. Yeah, that's looking pretty legit. Let's try 2. Oh, perfect. Bam. Look at that. Holy cow, that looks pretty good. All right, now I still have a little bit of geometry sticking out here. This wouldn't be sharp, that sharp on a regular car. So I'm gonna cheat, grab this, and I don't want the surface, just want the edges. Ooh, and I don't want that edge. I want that edge, and I want that edge. Right click, down to fillet. And I'm just gonna use a super tiny fillet. Let's try 0.1. Oh, perfect. Look at that, it's pretty legit. Now I can go ahead and I can start taking some of this additional geometry and fixing it by grabbing the edges. And this is just a junkyard way to do this. But when you're first starting out, this is the easiest way to learn. When I say this is a junkyard way to do this, the pros use a different, they use a whole different process. I didn't want to do chamfer, I wanted to do fillet. They actually start with shells and they do something called shell modeling for a process like this, but I'm just showing you this is a super easy way to cheat. And if you're making like a model that's only like 6 inches long and it's not that big, this is going to look fantastic. So this is the junkyard way to do this. All right, let's go in. I just want to go in a tiny bit. See how it's not letting me? It's because the geometry's getting messed up. But it'll let you do it if it's, see, I just want a little bit, just a tiny bit. So it'll let me do it if it doesn't screw up too much other geometry. Yeah, it looks pretty good. And now I'm gonna start detailing some of these other aspects and smoothing them out. And if you try to do too many parts at one time, sometimes it won't let you, so you have to do them individually. So let's try to just trying to gangster through this. So I'm gonna keep using the same technique and I'm just gonna keep beating this thing into submission. So if it doesn't like it, I'll try a different, you know, a different size on each one of these. 0.05, let's try that. Nope, it still hates me. It's because this little guy right here. Let's see if we can, oh, I don't want to chamfer it, I want to fillet it. Bam! Let's see if we can go a little bit higher than that. Let's try 1. Ooh, no, that's not what I want to do. I want to do 0.1. Yeah, that's pretty good. And if you get little artifacts or anything weird like this, sometimes you can just delete it. And it'll fix it for you. What? Isn't that amazing? Shit's so cool. All right. 0.1. What? It worked. Awesome. You see how I'm just beating this thing into submission? Dude, professionals are just turning over right now. They're right rolling their eyes because this is just a gangster way of doing this. More like a junkyard way of doing this. But hell, it works, man. Especially for the layperson, this is an awesome way to get a pretty good product, especially for a small model. Man, this is the way to go. All right, now I'm going to go in and start doing a few of the details on the side too. And the way I'm going to do it is just go back to my sketch and remember what I showed you. All you have to do is just beat this thing into submission, create some geometry, and then start moving it around. So that's what I'm going to start doing next. So I know this goes all the way out to right there, right? I think so. Yeah, that's the way it works. Okay, that one's easy. Let's try this one. No, just beat it into submission. Bam. It's like, what are you doing to me? All right, pull this bad boy out. No, I'm just gonna. You can do it either way. You can pull it, but that'll pull it straight out. I don't want to move it around, mess with it. Let me get to where I can see it. Right, yeah, right about there. And then I'm gonna twist this bad boy. Oh, it doesn't like that. It because it's trying to twist it from the middle. I can adjust that. All right, let's just leave it where it's at. Just leave it where it's at. Okay, hit cancel. I'm gonna pull it out to right about there. Oh, you know what I could do? I could look at the front of this thing and see exactly how far it goes across. But I'm just trying to be fast. Okay, now I'm gonna move it. Now remember, it's gonna wanna move it from the center somewhere, and I don't wanna do that. See how the pivot's right there? I'm gonna move the pivot right here. Say yes, that's where I want to move it. And then I'm going to pull it out. Yeah, good place to start, at least. And what we'll do is we'll end up going in here and adding some lights that look a little bit separate. So, good start right there. This little guy. Once again, it's like, ow, dude, what are you doing to me? Just giving you some a little bit of definition. You know, I like looking at things holistically. It helps me visualize what I'm actually doing. So let's update the other side. The easiest way to do it is remember our construction plane. Go here. I'm gonna split this body. Bam. Splitting tool, that guy. Okay, that gives me an extra body. Make sure you delete the right one. Delete. I can get rid of this now. Here, mirror. This body, this plane, and then boom. Now I can see how my charger's starting to come together. So I'm just finishing up a few more tiny details on the side, and we'll be good to go. I'm just going to push these into the side. Remember, that just gives me the ability, once I create the geometry, to go back in here and do what I want with it. So with these, remember, I just want the pivot up at the top. So I move that pivot point. Say right there is fine. Remember, I have to say that's exactly where I want it. And let me make sure I grab the right handle there. There it is. Yeah, it looks pretty good. Remember, this is a tiny model. Remember, this is only like 6 inches across. So I just want to be able to define these windows so they look correct. I'm gonna move this out just a tiny bit. Nope. Cool thing about Fusion, if you want to move something a smaller amount, just zoom in and then try to move it, and it'll move it in smaller increments. See? All right, that's good. That's where I want it. at this point. And remember, I have to change the pivot, so I'm going to do this in two moves. I'm going to try to move this again. Set the pivot up here at the top. I want it on that edge right there somewhere. Yes. The reason you have to click yes, you know, or that second click is because the first click is you're telling it where you want the pivot. So I'll show you again. First click is you're telling it you want to move the pivot. But what's cool is that, so that's the first click, but then I can change the orientation of the pivot, and that's what that second click is. And once you're done with that second, if you want to adjust it, then you click ready to move. So that's good. All right, so our side details are done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the front window and the back window, and we'll be good for details. So I'm in the sketch again, right here. I've got it, that front sketch. But remember, the side with details that I just got done working with is on the right-hand side over here. But my front sketch is on the left-hand side. Well, there's a simple, very simple solution here. And what I wanted to do is I wanted to put a window in. So, but I want it to be on this side. So I can just draw it, but I want to show you another trick that you can do. So I'm just putting this in, and I want to use a curve here. Boom. Kind of come out there into right about there. Okay. Now I'm going to use a regular line all the way across. Okay. So cool thing about sketches is, let me watch happens if I can hide the stuff behind it so I can show you what I'm doing. Cool thing about sketches is you can always mirror stuff inside sketches too. So I go down to my menu, I go to mirror. First thing it wants me to tell it is which objects I want it to mirror. I want these. Then you have to give it a line. And obviously I want my center line to mirror, and hit OK. And now I have that geometry on the other side. Hit finish sketch. And then that gives me the ability to take this. Remember, all I need to do is generate that geometry on my model. So that's the geometry I want right there. And remember, once again, you only do stuff to one half of your model. That way you can fix it. So remember this plane I had down here? I'm going to use that again. I'm going to go up here, split body, one body here, and splitting tool. I want it to be this. Hit OK. That gives me two bodies now, so I'll go up to my body menu. Grab the right one. And then now I'm going to hide this so you can see what I'm doing. And now I'm gonna move this out. I'm gonna do it in two moves. I'm gonna move the first move. Remember, I'm gonna zoom in so it moves it in smaller increments. My first move is going to be to right there. And I want this to line up as well. And my pivot's already in the right direction, so I'm gonna zoom in so it does it in a smaller amount. I need it to do a little bit less than that. And if you have trouble, see how it's 5 degrees, then I'll just type it in. Do -2. Bam, that's where I want it. That looks good. Okay, and then the second move, I want it to flex out. Notice with my model in half, it makes it a lot easier. A lot of times when you work on geometry, it's easier to work on it when your model's split. So I'm going to set this pivot up here at the top. I just wanted to set it along this edge. Tell it that's where I want it. And then I'm going to go out. And then I have a pretty good windshield. Hey, for a 6-inch model, I would normally be done at this point because it defines it, it shows it, and you really wouldn't notice because this model's so small. But hey, glass, especially windshields, are not flat. So I'll show you how to fix this really quickly, and it's super easy. I'm gonna create a sketch on that, on that plane that cuts my model in half. And remember, what's cool is I can pull geometry. So project include, and I am going to project. I want these curves right here. All right, now that I have those curves, and I want to get this top part too. All right, that looks good. Now I'm going to grab this geometry too. Now you'll see the reason why I do that. And remember, if it gets wonky, you can always get it there. Is I need that geometry just as a reference. Okay, so I'm good. Hit okay. So now I have that geometry. Now, this is really cool. Cool thing you can do inside sketches is I'm going to select that entire front curve. And then I'm going to use this little tool called the offset tool. And what that allows me to do is draw the same line, but offset to where it was originally. Bam. See how it drew a second line in there? We'll check that out. Now that line intersects with this line, so that should give me a piece that I can now push across. Once again, this is junkyard modeling. Okay, I want it to go right there. Remember when you push a piece across another piece, it automatically goes into cut mode. I don't want it to cut, I want it to join. All right, so we're lucky, and this is why it's so cool. I love these blueprints you can find on the internet. I'm gonna move this because this one's awesome because it not only gave us a front view, it gave us a rear view. So I'm gonna make the window from the rear view. All I really need to do is turn this around backwards, 180 degrees, then move it back. And now I'm just gonna line it up. To make sure I'm looking at it correctly, I remember I'm gonna go over here and make sure I'm looking directly on. All right. Wow, that looks pretty dang good right there. Yep, that looks pretty good. Okay. Now, remember, now I need somewhere to put my sketch, and there's no good surface. I don't know that any of these surfaces are exactly 90 degrees, so I'm going to make sure I have a surface that is 90 degrees. I'm going to go back over here to origin so it shows back up, offset plane, and then I'm going to pull a plane right up against my sketch. All right. Doesn't have to be right on, but it helps if it's right on your, it's just above or right on line with your canvas. All right, so I'm gonna create a sketch on that canvas. It does all the hard work for me. Now I'm gonna come in and I am going to create this curve right there. Okay, let me back up so I can see. Okay, make sure I know what I'm looking at. And then I'm gonna grab this line right here. Now, notice where now I can tell it to go straight down from this, but you see how I went up and grabbed that? I'm not clicking anything, but I'm just telling it, hey, I want you to align off that. Okay. So notice that my fin back here is actually in the way a little bit, but I can trick it by doing this. I want to hide this now, and I can actually move this sketch around if I want. So grab the sketch, move. And I'll move it in. So that way, when I push and pull, it doesn't hit my fin. Okay. Once again, I'm just creating the geometry. Get rid of my sketch. Grab my window. I'm gonna pull it out. And I'm gonna tilt it. Uh-oh. Got weird on me. Cancel. Let's try that again. Remember, if it gets weird, just, you know, kind of bang on it, man, and get it to do what you want. And a lot of times it's as easy as trying to do it in two moves, not just one. So, all right, see what I'm saying? That's like my first move. This time I'm gonna tilt it using one of these lines up in here. So what I'm doing is adjusting my pivot point. See, oh, doesn't want to move where I want it to. That's all right. Remember, you can just go in and adjust it. So let's try 2. Nope, other direction. So it was 5, so let's try 7. A little bit more. We need a little bit more. 9. Ooh, it looks pretty good. I could do the same thing I did with that front windshield to get the curve, but I don't really care. It's just the back windshield. It's just the back window anyway. Remember, small model, not a big deal. Okay, let's see what we got. Create mirror. Grab the whole body. Hey. All right, let's get some wheels knocked out real quick. This shouldn't take very long at all. Go back to my original sketch. Remember, I'm just creating the geometry. So I will take this one first. Both of those, press pull. One thing you can do here, I'm just gonna eyeball it. But you can use your sketch to make sure your wheels are the right size as well. Okay. Now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to push this out. Actually, I'm going to do this a different way. That's easier. I'm going to grab this sketch, and I'm going to move it a little bit. Just a tiny bit. Okay. And now that gives me... Now, when I move it, it'll automatically... So right-click, press pull. I'm gonna do 2 sides, and I don't want it symmetric. I just wanna be able to do each side separate. So I'm gonna pull this out to right about there is good, and pull that side out. For this model, if I was gonna 3D print this, I would make the back sides of the wheels. I would on purpose make them flat so I could print them that way. And last but not least, let's, all right, now let's push the middle part of the wheel out. I'm gonna go out. Now, what's cool is if you want it to line up with something else, you have to start it. So you have to pull it a little bit. But once you have it pulled, now you can click on other geometry and it'll go out to the same length as that geometry. Obviously, now I need a center. So let me edit this sketch. Need a center hub. Let's say 0.25. Let's do 0.25. The reason is because I'm going to make this an actual where the wheels move. Finish. Whoa. Alright, now I'm just going to push a hole right through this. Remember, automatically it cuts, so that's all I had to do. Okay, get rid of this sketch. let's go in here and work on this wheel a little bit. Once again, I'm going to junkyard this wheel real quick. I'm going to select that edge, I'm going to fillet, or fillet, sorry, I keep saying fillet, like a fillet of fish. Make a good looking wheel. Then I am going to grab this edge, and then I'm going to chamfer. Leave some detail in there so it looks like a real wheel. Bam. And do the same thing with this one. Cool. Wheels are done. Now you can do a lot of tricks and you can do all sorts of cool stuff. I can show you how you can do patterns and things like that. You can use to create spokes and all that beyond the scope of this one. So I just wanted to make a quick wheel for this model. Okay, I'm going to speed through this next part, but I'm going to explain really quick what I'm doing. I'm going to grab, we only have two bodies in this complex model. It's crazy. All right, I'm going to put this wheel right up against, I'm going to bring it down to where it lines up pretty close in the middle with the bottom of my model, and I'll show you why I'm going to do that. Just because next, what I'm getting ready to do is I'm going to build a spoke on the bottom of this model so that these wheels will turn. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a sketch on the bottom. But I want my wheel out of the way. So there's a cool thing you can do. You can go down here to sketch, right click, slice sketch, and now it's sliced so that it takes everything out of the way. So now I'm going to build a little spoke for this, and I'm just going to go really quickly through it. Okay, I just wanted to show you, all I did was kind of build this hub, and I just used the same process as I was just showing you. It just took me a little while to figure out exactly how I kind of wanted it to come out. So that's the reason I didn't bother you with it, but it's really not that complex. Now I want to cut this hub in half so it squeezes together. So I need to cut the hub, but I don't want to cut the wheel. If you hide stuff before you cut things, it won't cut that other object, so that helps tremendously. So that's what I'm doing in this case. Bam. So now these two pieces, when it 3D prints, will squeeze together and our hub will work a little bit better. When it comes to 3D printing, you gotta get a little bit creative. So let me show you how I'm planning on splitting this model apart. I've got a chassis, got the chassis down here, and then the wheels are separate. Wheels are good to go, man. They'll print on that backside, no problem. For this, I need to split this model. I need to combine them together and then split it. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to do that real quick. So first of all, let's try to do it with an offset plane first. Let's see if that works. And let me hide. There it is. I want that offset plane to be the same as that right there. Okay. Let me hide these wheels so they don't get split. Okay, now I'm ready to split this the main body here. Nope. That is not what I wanted to do. Let's try that again. Split body. I want to split this. Splitting tool. I want it to be this plane. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine the bottom part of my chassis with this body, and then it'll just show you how to do it. That. I want them to join together. Okay. Now, if you notice what I did, check this out. If I take this body and I move it, now I know this body has a flat bottom. It'll print. Curves will print too. So you just have to avoid anything greater than like a 45 degree angle. But curves tend to do okay during 3D printing. So this body will print. Now, if you notice, this body looks a little shifty, but check it out. If I flip it upside down, it'll print perfectly because now it has a flat surface to print from. So now I know my model is good to go for 3D printing. So here's the fun part. All I have to do now is put my whole model together. And that's easy with the align tool. Just grab this surface. Notice I didn't grab a point. I just grabbed the surface. And if I grab a point, it'll go to that point. I want it just to go to the surface, so I'm going to click the surface. All right. And remember the easy part. Go over here to create. Mirror. Mirror plane. That. The objects. I want that one. And I want... Oh, it won't let me do them. I've seen this happen before. It's a glitch. You got to select the parts separately. Create mirror, that. Okay. And notice it's just joining automatically. Now, remember, now that I got rid of my plane in the middle, I don't have anything to go off of, but I remember I had this little guy still. So now I'm going to mirror, grab this wheel, and this wheel, and then use this as my mirror plane, and check it out. So last but not least, I just created a real primitive shape for the rearview mirror, and I'll show you how you solve this problem of 3D printing. All I'm going to do is take this body. I'm going to push it into this one, right? I'm not going to combine them yet, but remember, all you need for 3D printing is a little bit less than 45 degrees, or, you know, you can go a little bit higher than 45, but don't do much more than that. So you'll see what I'm going to do. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to give it a curve. And I'm kind of freestyling right now. All right, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this bottom part, and I'm going to move it. And since this is like a bottom part of the model, man, you're not going to notice this. So I'm going to make that. There's 45. You can go a little bit more than 45. So I'm going to go just a little bit more than 45. Okay. And then we're good to go. Now we got rearview mirrors and everything. Let me just pare these down just a little bit. Right now it's just a little too big. By the way, you probably thought you'd be able to do something like this. But believe it or not, it's really not that hard. I like to call this the cutout of a piece of wood modeling. And you just you just shave off the shapes off of a central point, and it's really not that bad. I mean, you can get some really, really good initial modeling, and this is a great way to work on your initial modeling skills. So before I do a 3D print, I always copy my model, and the reason I do that is because I want to go back and make good pictures of that original model. So I don't have to take it apart, put it back together, take it apart, put it back together. But laying out for 3D printing is pretty easy. All you're really doing is you're laying out your pieces to where they're all flat. So I'm taking this one, move, take this guy out. I'm gonna flip him over. Make sure it's 180. Okay. And then I'm gonna take my wheels. Okay, and obviously you're wondering, okay, how do I get everything to lie flat? Well, in Fusion, it's super easy. You can either, if you want it to all, you just have to find the plane that you want it to lie flat on. I'm gonna use the origin, so it gives me a good point. And so all you have to do is go is modify, align. And remember, if you just wanna move the piece, you start with the one you wanna move, and then you click on what you wanna move it to. So I move that down to that plane. And so, okay. If I do right click, I can always, you know, just go to my shortcut menu. Bam. Okay. And it'll give me the last move that I just did. So I want that one. Now I can align it to this because I know those are already aligned. All right, rendering really, really quick. And we're gonna go super fast and it's gonna be down and dirty. All you have to do is go from design. I told you the only other thing you'll really use is render. A lot of times it'll get weird on you. Just go back to home. All right, and go to materials, which is the color wheel up there. You can scroll down. I'm gonna go to paint, glossy. Let's do white. Initially, it's set to do to color the entire component or body, so that's okay. That's what we're doing right now. So, see, it says bodies and components. Now, if I just click faces, now I can do the individual faces. So let's do black for the windows. All right, you're gonna flip when you see this. This is one of my favorite things about Fusion. See this button right here? You go up to decal, insert from my computer, and use, best rule of thumb is to use PNGs because they have transparent backgrounds. So I want that to be about 90. Put it right, see there. Let's make that a little bigger. A little more obnoxious, you know what I'm saying? The reason it's disappearing right there is it's a different body, so I gotta fit it on this body. If I just combine those two bodies, it would fit. It would go across them, no problem. Tilt it just a little bit. It's too much, let's do 1 degree. There we go, looks pretty good. Okay. And then you just hit the in canvas render, and with the basic settings, it looks pretty stinking good.
Well, I told you it would be fast and furious. If you got any questions, you know where to check us out, commandodesigns.com. I'm Tony D.